Good afternoon, guys. Hope you're having a breezy morning in San Francisco today. So today we are going to talk about machine learning with the ERPs, how you can adopt it. So we are not talking about any of the rocket science. We're just talking about that, okay, how you can have a 30% growth from your top lines. I'm not talking about have a growth, have a talk about push your sales, how you can increase your things. It's just something, whatever you are using, how you can increase the 30% growth from the top line itself. And it's just out there with you in your silos. Is that out there available? You just need to utilize it. How you can utilize it? What are the different aspects you can do it? So that's what we're going to talk about today. Like, what are the different challenges that people face? What are the things that we can optimize? And how we can do all those things? So just to give you some brief about, like, my name is Maharshi Pancholi. I'm a part of a Brainvire Infotech. I'm a business analyst there. So I come from a good technological background. So I'm statisticians come computer engineering guy, providing a techno-functional things, help machine learnings and artificial intelligence to multiple SMEs and Fortune 500 companies as well. It's just about like how we adopt the different technologies to make out the growth stories out there. First, we talk about that, okay, like everybody of us uses different software suites. Either talk about CRM, ERPs, e-commerce, whatever we have. What we have is we have thousands of data available out there. If you talk about payrolls, if you talk about sales orders, if you talk about CRM, leads, opportunities, your logistics, warehouse, you have a silos available. But do you utilize it? No. Is there something you enter, you type the information, you take out the reports, that's it. Month end does, nothing else, you do it. So that's what we talk about, like what to do with those kind of silos. Do we need to utilize it somewhere? And if yes, then how we can utilize those things. So we're going to talk about like different modules, different activities of your industries, and we can touch base that, okay, what going to take about it. So let's say talk about simple employee expenses. How we can talk about like I'm tracking down the employee expenses and how we can adopt, utilize those things, and next time how to provide more grants out there. So first of all, we're going to talk about, are we using a smart ERP or are we using a dumb ERP exactly? So how many of you feel that, okay, you are using a smart ERP? Oh, wow. Cool. I'll just give you an example. So what you do is, like, let's say I'm going for a purchasing of one product. It's called Corner Desk Black. And I'm going with the one vendor, it's Wood Corner. So on the one specific day, let's say 4th of October, I'm going to purchase out of $5, you know, like one product. Next day, or the same day, I'm going to make out another PO out there. And I'm going to order 3 quantities and at a $50. And still, it does allow. Wow. If it is allowed, then your CEO is awesome. Because that's like you purchase something on $5 and again you are making a purchase on $50. There has to be something. There has to be utilizations. How any ERP can allow such kind of a things? How any business can allow? Do you think any of your business allow this? Any of your businesses, like any of your purchase officers or something will allow this? No, because if it is, like they will kick our ass. That, okay, why you are making a purchase like that? So it's just a simple things that, okay, why to the ERP cannot come back and they can say that, okay, you make out a purchase last time, the same product at $5. This was your min-max, this is your inventory, this is what's like your on-hand quantity as well. So why we cannot utilize those data out there which is available? And just to pop up, just to make out a workflows out there, just that, okay, you purchase something, if there is a difference of a 10%, 20% of variations, go to managers, go to approvals, those kind of things need to approve. Like, is this a machine learning? No. This is a common sense out there. So we just talk about first about a common sense that we can utilize it. So such kind of things are many, those are available, which the data are there, which we are using for our day-to-day businesses, but still we don't opt for it, like why you should not have it. Those are the few things that, okay, how the exact machine learning, that's the rocket science that we are talking about. So how we can help with the making out the right choices, preventing damages, better inventory managements, better the sales cycles, and managing of organizings and preparing for the futures as well. It's all about predictings, right? So first talk about, when we talk first things, is first is about identifying the outlier. So all the data that you have, we talked about expense management. So let's say I did 10 trips to Las Vegas. On 9 trips, I made out like $2,000. That's all my expense. In one trip, I make out of $5,000. So that was an outlier. So your ERP, your system, should be able to recognize such kind of a things. That, okay, this is something that is going as an odd, and pick those odds and showcase it, highlight it. So at least people would be aware about it, that, okay, this is outliers and this needs to be taken care of it. Then we have the voice for the new ERP. Everybody is going with the different kind of a things. Like first was a computer, then it was a mobile, then we talk about watches, and now it is a voice. How cool is that? Let's say I'm a CEO of a company, and if I wanted to know that, okay, what was my today's sales? Do I need to log into an ERP and I need to get out my reports? No, because even if I'm a CEO, I do have 200 people, I will not remember my ERP password as well. So it's just something, I will have my Alexa, I'll have my Google Homes, and I'll just say that, okay, hey, what was my today's sales? It gives me output. That's cool, right? You don't need to worry about anything else. Or nowadays, it's more something that, okay, in our device, we have an Android device, we have a Google Assistant, we have a Siri. So now it's a more assistive, even though you don't need those kind of devices as well. And there is a predictions that, okay, by 2022, like all the houses into majorly into US will be an Amazon Alexa or it will be a Google Home enabled. So even I'm at home, so then we'll be able to take in care that, okay, I don't need a laptop, I don't need a computer, I don't need a mobile. I just say that, okay, what was my today's inventory? How much, like, what was the output of my manufacturing? So those are just you take care and you get all the dates. So you talk about timesheets, you talk about project managements, and anything that you talk, you can manage it from it. And it's just that something that it's a voice command. So you don't need a report, you need a KPIs. KPI means that, okay, what was my today's expenses? What was, like, how many people come to my office today? So all such kind of a brief informations that we need out. Then, like, how we can use for the sales and CRM, which is one of the major, any of the business module out there. Every company need this. So what we talk about, like how we can have a best sales tactics, what works and what does not work. That makes sense. Like I'm making a 10 different calls to a customers. I'm making a 10 calls to Los Angeles customers, but it does not work. And I'm making a 2 calls to a New York customers and that works. So those kind of information is useful for any of your sales and marketing team out there. Then we have operational assistance. So if I'm a sales guy, then my ERP or my CRM should not be a roadblock for me, but it should be assistant to me. You know, everybody, like any of the new company who is adopting a CRM, one of the major pain points is, will my sales guy gonna use it? No, because it's a major pain point for them. And like now their things are going to track back. That's okay. Which are like how many calls you made, how many emails you made. But now we are going to an industry where salespeople exactly use those CRM. Why? Because we provide a more insights to it. We provide them, okay, we remind them that you need to do these activities. We remind them that, okay, you have a follow-ups to do. We automate them that, okay, we have, like, you send an email, 2 days happened, nothing responses. Go for it. Let's make out another thing. Then we talk about account classifications. How you classify different accounts, we'll be going to towards it, that what are the different algorithms, what are the different tactics you can use for the classification purposes. Customer satisfactions, that's we talk about. Individual proposals identifications and cross-sells, like how we can make out a cross-sells out there. So one of the major things that's your happiness, like when you have an e-commerce business, when you talk about, let's say, if anybody comes to your websites and he puts out the products to your cart and he goes back, what happens next? Nothing happens right now. But that is your much prospects lead out there. So you need to, there is a more targeted lead. They are interested in a product. They know your brand. They know your products. So it is why you not to worry about it. So whenever there is abandoned cart, so let's connect to our CRM. Let's connect a lead. Let's connect an opportunity for the abandoned carts. And then it goes to a salesperson. Even though better one is, whenever there is an opportunity, let's create for the, like, after 4 hours, let's send us discounts to them. 5% discount for your cart that you have. Still not purchased, after 12 hours, 10% discount. After 24 hours, assign to your sales team. That's what the simple is. And again, this is a machine learning? No, it's not a machine learning. It's a common sense. It's a normal utilization of ERPs, how you can utilize the data, how you can connect with the other things, and how you can have a better things out there. Now we are going to talk about a machine learnings. So what are the different things you can, till now, whatever we have covered, it was just about like how we can utilize the software suites in a best possible manner. So first is price optimizations via linear regression model. So I will not going to do like, okay, what is a linear regressions and everything, because I know that's not the technical that's we needed. So what we are talking over here is sales versus MRP. So if you think that, okay, if your MRP is low and sales is high, then you might be wrong at certain times. So it's might some many times it's possible. If you increase your MRP, your sales can also be higher as well. So those you talk about, those are the like keys. It's your sales predictions, it's your MRP, those are the sales. And then you mark out that, okay, what is your specific line of actions? What is MRP increment or MRP decrement that you're doing, which is making a significant points to your sales out there? So that you can define what is the range out there, what you need to do as a next, what you need to talk about it. So that's how you implement a price optimizations. What product price you need to identify. What should be the best increment or decrement that you can adopt for it. Then we have a sales predictions, which is the very useful things out there. Everybody needs it. That, okay, if I'm a salesperson, I'm a business person, I'm a sales manager, then I need that, okay, what kind of a predictions that we are talking about, where we are heading towards. So everybody, right now, our all ERPs, what they can achieve is, whatever the sales you have made out, you can see that reports that, okay, this day at this many sales, this day is this many sales. But what about futures? How you take about your funnels? You know, you have a funnels, like in, you have a 10 opportunities with a 75% ratio, probabilities out there. Let's make out a predictions out of it. Let's make the machine work for you. That you can utilize, and then you can make out predictions. That's okay, what is the sales is happening. Then we talk about the customer segmentations. So we talk about RFM. So RFM stands for recency, frequency, and monetary values. So whenever you have a customer, segment it. So let's say if your customers, how many are high spenders, mid spenders, recessions, and a low spenders. So this will be critical information for your business out there. Because right now, it's all your customers. There is no differentiations out there. So let's make out that, okay, when they make out a last purchase, how many number of purchases they did, and what is the net revenue they come to the company out it. And then you can segment and you can assign the teams out of it. Thus, I know we are talking more about sales and sales because that is one of the growth stories that we talk about. That's like one of the major pain points out of that. This is one of the other customer segmentations that we talk about. What is the customer value and what is the potential value? If customer is happy, customer is not happy. But with if customer is happy and if it is making a loss to my business, that is not a good customer journey out there. We wanted to make sure customer is happy and he's making a more business to my company as well. So that's how we segment. So first is light. So like how many, like 440 days they make out of one purchase, and this is a per, like per purchase dollar revenues that I get it. Then if there is a new customers, every new customers, what are the revenues that they come up? And how many number of customers are? How many customers are disengaged and how many customers are stars? Stars means they're coming up with the more revenues and they keep purchasing more and their satisfaction level is also higher at them. So how this helps is it can help you to organize your funnels. Then we talk about predicting the next purchase date. We have all the customers' data. Like when they make out a purchases, when they make out a last significant things, when they come to my e-commerce websites, when they have opportunities, when my salesperson's made out a last call to them. So all the data that you have, with that, you can utilize like what would be your next purchase days. So what you can have is that, okay, you have a historical customer lifetime value. You make out a predictions that, okay, normally according to this customer segmentations where he lies, the classifications he is in, and accordingly, this is the next purchase date. And you can also predict the customer's lifetime value as well. That, okay, this year, what will be the customer lifetime value also? So those will be important informations for you and overall for your business as a sales manager or a sales executives as well. This is a customer churn. So every business does need this. Like your customers are going away, they are churning out. So how to make sure that, okay, if they are not churning, so what kind of information that we need to put up? Like how many service calls? So generally, everybody of us, like am either you using a Odoo or not using Odoo or any ERP ticketing systems or anything. So you have like number of service calls that they make. So you can identify that, okay, if customer is making a 2 service calls, means he's now churning out. Customer is making 5 service calls, what is the probability that, okay, he will go away? So that kind of information is useful. Plus with that, information is useful in terms of that, okay, which customer segment will go out as well. Like from where they comes in and where they goes out. So this is like, okay, like what is the number of service calls they made out and what is the churn probability? So in that, we use a algorithm called logistic regressions, and that we can adopt such kind of things. Another one is lead scoring. We talk about like in the keynote also, we did that, okay, now the lead scoring happens automatically. So it's not only about lead scoring, it's also about classification of your customers as well. Sometimes one business value, let's say if you are into B2B business and your customer is about like $10 million of worth of customers. So then you need to provide a higher lead scoring to them. Then you provide the better services. Then you provide a different kind of a personalization touch to them. So those informations that you need to take care. So you need to bifurcate those customers onto a different variables. And from there, you can take it up that, okay, where they should stand for and whom they can assign to. So that's a K-min classifications that we can do. So if you can think of that, okay, like whatever we are talking about, it's nothing that, okay, we need to do any kind of a manual processes. It's just something we need to adopt plug and play things, and then your ERP itself will be able to provide such kind of a output for you. It's all data is available out there. You are just using those data to get this output for you. Then one of the point is customer 360 value. So everybody is talking about 360. Everybody is talking about we need to get a complete overview of it. So what we can do is, so one of the important KPIs is when they make out the first purchase, when they make out a last purchase, what is the customer lifetime value, how much total revenues they have made out, how many products they have purchased, and what is the average revenue that we are making out. Plus, with that, if you are connected with your e-commerce, if you are connected with your website, or anywhere else as well, you need to log in that, okay, how many times he has visited your website, how many times they have visited your e-commerce. Then, how many tickets are open? How many cases are there? High priorities, medium priorities, and low priorities. When you're making your next call, so you'll be able to understand that, okay, I'm going to get abuses from my customers, or it will be happy face of my customers. So I can make out my sales plan for him. So that's we can define it. Then we have all this data that, okay, last 10 product purchases, what was the orders, what was the order values and other things. We have his wish list. We have his, like, what are the products they have browsed towards it. We have that, okay, what is the abandoned cart. We can utilize all this kind of a data, and we can have a next action plan. Because consider a fact, I have added my product into a wish list, and it is also an abandoned cart. So it's a 90% of probability that person is going to make out a purchase of that. So that's kind of a value propositions that you are providing to your team. And that's how we are making a next level of CRM or next level of sales people that, okay, they can utilize it and they can make out a better sales. These are the more informations about like when they make out a purchases, when what's happening. So one of the important is many times like we make out a sales. that, okay, I have made our sales and then I need to 10 times call him. So there is a no benefit to the customer, no benefit to the company. So we need to make sure that, okay, if I'm making a sales, it has to be profitable to company. Next one is how many calls I'm making and then it gets converted to a sales. So, and what is the trend analysis? Sometimes many customers only purchase in December. Sometimes many customers purchase into only a fall. So we need to capture those data and accordingly we can plan that, okay, next time when I need to call them. Sometimes customers say that, okay, if you make a 10 emails, 5 calls, and then only the closing will happen. So those information if you already have, so you are prepared that, okay, you need to at least make out a 10 calls and 5 emails to get it done. This is something that we talk about sales and CRM. This is something into manufacturing and procurement. So what, how we can utilize? So we can use a predictive analysis for the raw materials. How we can implement that, okay, based on all your manufacturing and sales data, we can define that, okay, what raw materials you need. You can have a better supply chains and we can have a forecasting for the demands as well. Assembly lines planning, we have a configure price quotations and the vendor selection. Vendor selection is one of the important things. You know, you have your tickets, you have your orders, you have your warranties. So all this data you can capture together and you can select a better vendors. Next time, which vendors to go? Because every time, like if there is a 5% of change price of between different vendors and still we are choosing it. But then other things also depends as well. So this is a bottleneck of assets. This is a very standard scenario for any of the companies. You have a 5 different assets, you have a different suppliers, and out of that, 2 assets are depend on the other assets as well. And you have a mixed match of suppliers also. So in this case, you need to talk about predictive maintenance, you need to talk about yield throughputs, and supply chain dynamics optimizations. Because when we talk about, okay, I want asset 4, how we can make out a better supply chain solutions so my asset 4 does not go to any time of a low stock, and my suppliers are providing in a better way. This is something about soft tickets. We like our major business, like our customer supports and our ticketing systems. So we have automated priority of tickets. Anytime tickets generated, it gets assigned that, okay, it is high priority, low priority, what it is. And another major is sentiment analysis. Whatever they have written into their email body or the tickets, we can understand that, okay, what kind of reactions they are, what kind of a mindset they are. They are very angry. Or they are like into a light mode. Accordingly, you can set out tickets and you can assign the people as well. Then you can that, okay, which peoples are available, you can assign the support tickets and other things. We have like chatbot solutions so that, okay, it can integrate with your sales, it can integrate your tickets and can automatically provide output to them. This is just something I wanted to give, like there was a company called Romanoff. So it is a Long Island, New York based company. So they were using around like 25 years old system, but still intelligent systems. So still they were providing, catching all data and everything. And we have transformed them a new systems with the Udo ERP and everything. And we provided lots of insights. So they have around like 15 odd salespeople out there. We implemented them with the Udo ERP and all this machine learning tactics inside it. And from where we can get it out that, okay, what kind of utilizations we can do and what kind of a better insights we provide. So 25 years old systems to a new system, data capturing and still providing insights to them. So that's what we have captured. And this is about our company. This is like where we work at a Brainwire. And we have our Udo department head as well, Chirag. So like we all together, we are able to capture the things we were able to serve in this ways. So yep, that's from our end. Thank you so much for listening. Any questions?
Hi.
Hey.
Regarding the predictive analysis for raw materials, how much data do you need for sales and purchase? How back behind do you need data?
So it's about like what is the probability. So if you have around like a 4 to 6 months of data, you can reach to 80 to 85% of accuracy. The more data you have, the more better accuracy is, but around 4 to 6 months is needed.
And what happens in this scenario? Let's say you have a big customer, and then the customer is no longer with you. So the probability.
So yes, so if those customers are not with us, but still their history is with us, so we can understand, okay, what kind of a customer journey we had, and that helps to classify the other customers. So let's say if you have a one B2B customers, that's going to similar to act other B2B customer as well. So that one data can help you to identify the other B customers data as well. Yeah.
So I saw you had the sentiment analysis feature tied to the ticketing
system.
Are you looking at implementing that in other areas in Odoo where you get customer feedback on the portal on sales orders, invoices, something like that, to maybe assist with predictive analysis for leads with particular?
Definitely. So one of the better ways, like whenever we are making an orders, then automatic like feedback form should go, and then we capture that, okay, like what was their experience and everything, and from there we can get a sentiment. But the ticketing was something where we get a more customer exact feedback, and it is more useful that, okay, if it is a high priority ticket, medium priority tickets, or low priority tickets. Because many times, like from the wordings, I'm not able to understand that, okay, I need to take out a high or low, but from sentimental, I can get a more better insights inside it. Cool, thank you.